Hello everyone, and welcome to Nancy Drew the Haunted Carousel. You know the drill. I've never played this game before, I don't know anything about it, so let's get right into it.
Welcome to my latest case, the Haunted Carousel. To start playing, choose either junior or senior detective. If you're new to adventure games or need some help, choose tutorial.
Junior, please.
Dear Ned, well, here I am at Captain's Cove Amusement Park, about to try to figure out what's behind all the weird things that have been happening here lately. First, a horse just disappeared off the carousel one night. Then, a little later, the carousel started spinning around all by itself in the dead of night, as if it was haunted or something. And then, last week, the roller coaster suddenly stopped in mid-ride for no apparent reason. Nobody was seriously hurt, but the park was shut down until the city knows for sure what caused the accident. I'm here because Paula Santos, the park's owner, is a friend of Dad's. She's putting me up at the Captain's Quarters Hotel, which is next to the park. I'm supposed to head over there right now and meet with a security guard named Harlan Bishop. I hope I don't let Paula down. Wish me luck. Ever yours, Nancy. P.S. There's a rumor going around that the park is cursed. Creepy, huh?
Sounds fun. Oh yeah, I did look at the hint screen. And we have a cell phone now. I was just asking about that in the last game. Like, when was Nancy gonna get a cell phone? She has one. Yes. Also a laptop now, so that's cool. Well, even the hotel has carnival music. Oh, but we're not taking the laptop with us, it stays here? Okay, that's not as useful as I thought it might be then.
A room service menu, all right!
Oh, these sound pretty good. Ooh, Sunday, yum. I would like a sundae. When was the last time I had ice cream? It's been a while. Oh, but we do have a normal phone. Oh, it's a courtesy phone for the hotel.
Hotel operator, what do you want?
Are you the regular operator?
I'm filling in for my cousin Amber. She took the week off on account of the amusement park being shut down. You don't want an outside line, do you?
Actually, I have a cell phone.
Good. Use it. An outside line will cost you an arm and a leg. Besides, I'm not sure how to get you one. So, Ms. Arin, what do you want?
That's Drew. Nancy Drew?
Sorry, my cousin's handwriting reeks. So, what do you want, Ms. Drew?
Wait, I could just order food?
I'd like to order a Funday, please.
No can do. We're out of ice cream. Should be getting more in any minute.
Story of my life.
I'd like to order the pasta and veggie platter with orange juice instead of a soft drink, please.
Health nut, huh? Well, whatever. Anything else?
I just don't eat burgers.
That's it. Thanks a lot.
Don't mention it.
Oh. That was really fast.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What was the point? Besides making sure Nancy continues to function as a human being. Can I just order the other thing too?
Hotel operator, what do you want?
I'd like to order the hamburger platter with milk instead of a soft drink.
One hamburger platter with moo juice. It'll be there in a few. Anything else?
That's it. Thanks a lot.
Don't mention it.
Why am I allowed to do this?
Hmm.
Okay. Well, Nancy is very, very full now. Flag game. Now this makes the mouse lag a bit. I don't know why I'm doing this right now. I guess because the game is letting me. Who cares about solving crimes when you can just play computer games all day? I say as I play a computer game in my room at my house. Instead of doing anything else that might be important. I don't actually have anything more important to do right now, so... joke's on me, I guess? Okay. That was a fun waste of time. No, I don't want to play again. No! Inbox. Anyone trying to message me? Okay, I'm not allowed to mail anyone, but I can get mail. Sassy Detective Online. I'll get tips in my email? How does that work? Do they know what I'm doing right now? Are they spying on me? Okay, that's basically a... I have a checklist. Can I actually check these off? Well, I can't right now because I haven't done anything, but... okay, I got the Hardy Boys. I got Home. I got Bess. Okay, I should probably call... her.
Paula Santos.
Hello, Miss Santos. It's Nancy Drew.
Hello. Have you been out to the park?
No, not yet. I thought I'd check in with you first.
You're all set. I told the guard at the main gate to keep an eye out for you. His name's Harlan Bishop. All the rides are shut down except for the carousel. I thought you might need to see it in action, but please take a good look at the roller coaster even if you can't ride it.
What did the police find when they looked at it?
They looked around for 5 minutes, then left. Said as long as the insurance company was going to investigate, why should they?
Well, I'll see what I can do, Miss Santos.
I can't wait to hear what you turn up. Call me as often as you like. My phone's on and with me 24/7. Oh, and one more thing. Call me Paula.
All right. Goodbye, Paula.
Cool. Okay, they do check off. Yes. Good. Thank you. Thank you, game, for making improvements as you continue on with the series. Quality of life. Oh, yeah. Ooh. She has the same suitcase that she's had since the start, doesn't she? That's good continuity there.
Rolf Kessler.
Ooh, haunted house. Well, we know who built the carousel, or at least carved the horses. Ooh, I have a closet. I have an ironing board.
I need to turn the iron on.
Yay? Am I just ironing the ironing board? I think I am.
I need to turn the iron on.
I wonder if it'd be a game over if I left it turned on and left the hotel and then burned the hotel to the ground. That'd be kind of fun. Who doesn't like a little arson to start the day?
Will the young lady who just entered the park please turn immediately and enter the whale's mouth directly to her left? Thank you.
Here I come. Hi.
Well, from the way you just marched right on in here past all those sorry we're closed signs, you're either who I think you are or you're one determined gatecrasher.
If you think I'm Nancy Drew, you're right.
That's a relief. It's too early in the day to go sicking the cops on anybody. I'm Harlan Bishop.
Are you the only security guard on duty now?
I begged Miss Santos to keep me on while the park's closed. Even agreed to a pay cut.
You must really like your job.
I've only worked here for a couple of weeks. I figured staying on while the park was closed would help me get up to speed on all the equipment and such.
Where did you work before you came here?
Oh, I worked in a store. Department store. You know, as a security guard. In Flemington. Not around here.
That sounds a little suspicious. Why'd you hesitate so much?
How seriously do you think the police are taking this haunting stuff?
Somebody swiped a horse off a carousel and now it's malfunctioning. The police don't think it's that big a deal, and frankly, neither do I.
What about the roller coaster?
Accidents happen. Of course, Ingrid will tell you that these so-called accidents are really the result of the park's karma getting bent out of shape by negative energy or some such gobbledygook.
Who's Ingrid?
Ingrid Corey. You'll probably meet her. She's working during the shutdown, too. She's the park's chief engineer. Believes in all this wacky new age psychobiogenic stuff. Like if you eat food served by a waiter who's in a bad mood, you'll get scurvy or something.
Is anyone else in the park now?
Elliot Chen. He's the art director. Hardly ever see him. Busy guy. And Joy Trent, park bookkeeper. In fact, she's your next stop.
Ooh, there are four people here, is that right?
She is?
Miss Santos's orders. Joy pays all the bills, so she knows pretty much everything that's going on. Plus, she'll give you an access card. Miss Santos wants you to have the run of the place.
That would certainly help.
Wait, hang on. I know Joy won't give you one of these, so I will. Here you go. It's a Captain's Cove fun card. Lets you ride the rides and play the games on the midway.
Oh, cool, thanks.
Come back to me if you burn through that one and need another.
Am I not supposed to have this?
Well, see, Joy's just kind of joyless. It had never occurred to her that you might want to have some fun while you're here. Of course, she's a newbie too, like me. Maybe she'll come around. Anyway, here's a map of the park. I put an X where Joy's office is.
I see you have a security camera trained on the carousel. Does that mean you got the theft of that carousel horse on tape?
We didn't start monitoring the carousel until after the theft, but we do have one of those so-called hauntings on tape. Want to see it?
That'd be great!
I got the tape right here, all queued up. I played it for the police. Like I said before, they weren't real impressed. There's no sound, on the tape at least. The band organ started up when the carousel did. Stayed on for about 30 seconds, then stopped.
Did you notice that burst of static just before the carousel started to turn?
Probably just a glitch in the tape. We use them over and over.
Have you tried to prove your screwed-up wiring theory?
I ain't no cop. But now that you're here, maybe you can prove it for me.
I'll see you around.
Go get him.
Interesting. Okay, he's been pretty helpful so far. Hopefully we can trust him. Oh, he even made a list of the stuff to do with me.
The phone number for the police. That might come in handy.
Definitely. Write that down, Nancy. Okay, there's nothing over here as far as I can tell, except for some electrical boxes, which may be relevant later. Can I just sneak in people's lockers?
Please don't open that.
Sorry, bad habit.
Yeah, he is right behind us. I probably shouldn't be messing with this. And luckily the game will not let me. Thank you, game. Yeah, there's way too many high voltage signs for my comfort in here. Oh, okay, this is a cool way to get around. You even mark where the people are! Thank you! Okay, let's go talk to Joey then. Joy? Yeah, that's how you pronounce that, sorry. I don't know why I couldn't pronounce the word Joy for a minute. Hello!
Hello, are you Nancy?
Yes, I am. You're Joy?
Joy Trent. Sorry about the mess. So, I'm supposed to give you an access card.
No hurry. If you're in the middle of something, please go ahead and finish up.
That's okay. I'd just as soon get this little farce over.
What do you mean?
You're only here because it makes it look like Paula Santos had nothing to do with any of this curse garbage.
Are you saying she did have something to do with it?
I've seen how Paula runs the park. All she wants is to get more and more people through that gate. And what better way to do that than with a carousel that's allegedly haunted?
Well, I don't know if that would work considering the park is currently shut down. That's not getting more people through the gate.
But why would she sabotage the roller coaster? She can't make any money with a park shut down.
She probably just didn't know the park would be shut down.
Is Ms. Santos aware of the way you feel about her?
Of course not. I don't want to get fired. Besides, nobody's been hurt. Except that glorified con artist who claims his neck got injured, Lance Huffington. And the truth is, Paula offered me this job because she knew I needed the money. And I'm not entirely ungrateful. My father died recently. His estate is in bankruptcy. He used to be co-owner of the park. 2 years ago, he suffered a huge financial setback, and he had to sell his share to Paula. When he died 2 months ago, he was flat broke. Paula could have bailed him out, but she didn't. Frankly, I think the reason she hired me was guilt.
Okay, well, you have a motive.
Right. I'm supposed to get an access card from you?
Here you go. That should get you into all the private areas of the park. But if you run into problems, don't come to me. Ask the chief engineer, Ingrid Corey. Her office is by the haunted house. The only other people in the park right now are Harlan Bishop and the art director, Elliot Chin. His studio is right by the treasure chest souvenir shop. But try not to bug him.
Does he not like to be disturbed?
He's behind in his work and needs to catch up. Ms. Santos has been getting on my case about it. Well, I think you have everything, so if you'll excuse me?
Oh, right. Thanks for all your help. Sorry if I disturbed you.
I like her voice. Well, she certainly has a reason to have a grudge against Paula. Which could lead to her be willing to sabotage the park.
Okay, if I peek in here?
Go ahead and look around. Excuse all the clutter. I'm still trying to get this place organized.
But then again, if she was the culprit, would she tell us that she has a grudge against the park owner? Well, somebody agreed to sell one of the horses.
Looks like stenography. It's a memo about one of the carousel horses being sold. I wonder which horse.
We're gonna have to figure out how stenography works, and I definitely do not know. That is something I'm kind of fascinated by, though. Very fast note-taking. I'm jealous. Galaxy Ballroom. So the park has a very nautical theme to it. That's cool.
The haunted house used to be a ballroom. How's that for irony?
Interesting. Oh, this is the guy who's apparently a con artist. I wonder if we'll get to meet Mr. Lance Huffington.
Maybe I should give Detective Paris a call. Hey, hidden jewels. Maybe that's what whoever stole that carousel horse was after. Jewels from that heist.
Nancy, let me read it. Hold on. Okay, so a visitor to the park found a whole bunch of jewelry hidden in the backrest of one of the rides. Oh, there were items stolen from the hotel. Okay, the same hotel I'm staying at. The thief may have stashed the jewelry in various places throughout the park. Some valuable stuff could still be hidden in the park. Okay, and they posted this in a public newspaper. So anyone could have seen it and been like, oh, I'm going to the park to steal some jewels. So that means pretty much everyone's a suspect, as usual. Okay, we need to go talk to Ingrid. Oh. Okay, we don't need a code. Not at the moment, at least. I don't know if we can come back at a different time.
Do you mind?
Right, sorry.
Where are you? Oh, there you are. Hello, I like your hair.
Looking for someone?
I'm Nancy Drew. I'm trying to help Ms. Santos figure out why so many weird things have been happening around here lately. Do you have time to talk?
Sure. Oh my, you've got B3 issues.
What?
I do?
Vitamin B3, niacin. The vibe you're giving off tells me you're low. Nothing that some natural peanut butter on a slice of whole wheat bread once a day won't fix.
Oh man, she is really pretty. Oh man, I like her.
Thanks for the advice. How long have you worked here?
A little less than 2 years. I started out in maintenance and worked my way up. I've held the supervisory position for the last 10 months.
Do you have any idea what caused that roller coaster accident?
Someone stole a horse off the carousel, and now the park is cursed.
Okay, so she believes it. She's the only one so far. Besides maybe Paula, but she's the one hiring us or whatever, so she doesn't count.
So you think this cursed thing is real?
The man who carved the horses, Kessler, he said if they were ever separated, bad luck would follow. And it has.
Could I see the blueprints of the roller coaster so you can show me exactly where on the track it stopped?
I've looked all over for those blueprints and can't find them anywhere. I'm sure one of the other engineers knows where they are, but I'm afraid I don't. Sorry.
The blueprints are missing. Interesting.
How well do you know Harlan Bishop?
I know he's an ex-bouncer from Trenton. I also know it drives him nuts that this is one of the few places in the park he doesn't have a key for.
Okay, so he was lying to us about his previous job. I wonder why. Like, what's the point? If he told me he was a bouncer straight up, I'd be like, okay, sure. But now I'm suspicious because he was lying about it.
Any idea why someone would steal a horse off a carousel?
Money. I hear they can be very valuable.
Do you mind having to work during the shutdown?
Not a bit. Keeping those card readers functioning is practically a full-time job all by itself. Plus, I happen to adore my job.
Thanks for your help.
One open mind sees more than two open eyes.
I like her a lot. She's my favorite so far. Teacups. The last time me and my family went on vacation to Universal Studios, it was the first time I'd gone on, like, big roller coasters and stuff. Like, I went on the Incredible Hulk coaster, and that was really fun. But then my sister and I discovered the teacups, and we discovered that you can spin them really, really fast if you try, and suddenly that was the most intense ride in the park. It was a lot of fun. Okay, a car advertisement. Can I use your computer? No, I cannot. That's okay. And I can't snoop around in your stuff yet, because you don't want me to. So I'm probably going to have to come back at a time when you're not here. We should probably talk to Elliot. He might get mad at us, but...
Hang on, I'll be right with you.
Take your time.
Oh no.
Out. And do not come back unless and until Joy Trent calls me. Okay?
Okay.
That's a very bad first impression. Well. Okay, let's check out the carousel since that's where the main stuff is happening.
This takes a fun pass.
Let's go for a spin on the carousel. By the way, you have 4 fun credits left on your card. Enjoy the ride, haha. The carousel will be starting in 3 seconds, so hang on tight. And don't forget to try for the brass ring.
Yee-haw!
Huh, I got it. I win.
Here it comes again.
Did I die?
You're in the emergency room?
I fell off the carousel. I was trying to grab the brass ring and reached too far.
You were what?
It's kind of a long story. Uh-oh, I have to hang up now. They want to x-ray my head.
I should probably come down there and have my head examined too. What was I thinking, asking you to play detective? Well, I know what I'm thinking now. You're off the case.
That was amazing.
The carousel will be starting in 3 seconds, so hang on tight. Don't forget to try for the brass ring.
Yee-haw!
Oh, that was glorious. I was hoping we get to examine the actual carousel. Oh, we can, as long as I don't ride it. Oh, are these the names of the horses? Moonglow? Rolf Kessler.
This takes an employee access card.
I can't get in? Okay. What about this one? No?
This takes an employee access card.
Okay. We'll have to come back to that then. I like how the screws and all the debris stayed perfectly in place while the ride was spinning. Okay, well, I don't think we can go anywhere else on the carousel. That's okay, we looked at what we needed to. Let's check the roller coaster. I like that. That's cool.
It's locked. I wonder what the deal is with this red tag.
We probably shouldn't mess with this, Nancy. Yeah, we shouldn't mess with this, Nancy. I'm not an electrician. And I doubt you are. This is how many times you've electrocuted yourself. Sounds like I'm going to have to fix it myself, probably. I don't know why. That's not a good idea.
It's locked.
So I guess the card reader here is not currently functioning. I guess we should tell Ingrid about that.
Hello, Nancy. Still on the case, I see.
I'd like to take a closer look at the roller coaster, but the access card reader doesn't work. It's got this red tag on it.
Right. I was in the process of upgrading its main circuitry board. I'm afraid you're going to have to wait until I finish here. Unless you'd like to do it for me.
Do you really think I could handle it?
It's not exactly brain surgery. All you have to do is follow the schematic inside the reader. Here's the new macro resistor. When you see the board, you'll be able to see where it goes. You'll need to solder it in place. Which means you're going to have to get my soldering gun from Elliot Chen. Here's the engineering handbook I put together. If you have questions about park-related electronics, it'll answer them. Keep it as long as you like.
Edited by Petite Altogether.
When you're all done, remove the red tag and take it to Harlan. That way he'll know it's safe to turn the power back on to the reader.
That's not my cell phone. It must be yours. Are you going to answer it?
No, that would be rude. I'll just call them back. So, once you get that tool from Elliot, you should be all set.
I don't seem to be having much luck using my access card. Am I doing something wrong?
I deactivated most of the readers because of the shutdown. Soon as I get done here, I'll get them online again. Sorry. Hey, if you come across a pair of pliers, hang on to them, okay? Mine are missing. Someone must have walked off with them.
Thanks for your help.
You bet.
Alrighty. I don't think Elliot wants to talk to us.
Haven't heard from Joy yet. Out.
Okay, we need to talk to Joy then. She is.
Who are you, and what are you doing?
Who said that?
I said that over here, on top of the cabinet.
Hello, robot friend.
Keep going. Over here. Please identify yourself.
I'm a detective named Nancy Drew, and you are?
I am
Miles, the Magnificent Memory Machine.
I receive and process video and audio input and make appropriate pre-programmed verbal responses.
Who programmed you?
It is my turn to ask a question.
Nancy Drew,
why are you here when Joy is not?
As a matter of fact, I need to leave a message for her.
There is a pad for leaving messages on the desk.
So, who programmed you?
Responding to the non-Joy entity is an unnecessary drain on my power units and is heretofore disallowed.
What does that mean? Hello? Miles? I guess it means he's not going to talk to me anymore.
Robot friend.
Responding is an unnecessary drain on my power unit.
I love robot friend. No, Nancy, turn around.
I can use this to leave a note for Joy to call Elliot.
Cool. Is there anything else I can look at over here? Not really. Okay. In that case, I'm gonna go check out the haunted house.
Hello?
Hi, Nancy. It's Paula Santos. You know, I just had a thought. There's a newspaper article and photo in Joy's office that I want you to be sure to take a look at. They're in a frame on the wall.
I may have seen them. What are they about?
They're a little piece of park history. The guy in the photo found a bunch of jewels that had been stolen in a heist years ago and stashed away on one of the rides at Captain's Cove. The police said there was a good chance more jewels would turn up.
Maybe that's why someone stole that carousel horse, because there were jewels hidden inside it.
My thoughts exactly. I called the detective that was in charge of the investigation back then. His name is KJ Paris. He's going to call you. Oops, I gotta run. I just wanted to give you a heads up.
All right. Goodbye, Paula.
Sorry about that, I got interrupted. So, what were we doing again? Oh yeah. Odd sounds from below.
What is that noise? Sounds like it's coming from below.
Well, we're just carrying around an entire keyboard now.
Just an old radiator.
Well, we can't do anything with that right now. Why do I feel like we're going to have some sort of timed puzzle in that room? Let's talk to Harlan.
Hello?
This is Detective KJ Paris, Captain's Cove Police Department. Paula Santos asked me to call you. Said it concerned that heist out at Captain's Quarters 23 years ago.
Well, I was thinking maybe the reason that horse was stolen off the carousel at Captain's Cove 2 weeks ago was because somebody thought there were jewels from that heist inside it.
Never occurred to me, but it's possible, I suppose. The thief's name was Chaz Dunning. Died in prison about a year ago. I'll tell you what. I'll make some calls, try to see if there was somebody he confided in before he died. Somebody who was recently released.
That would be fantastic.
Well, as soon as I know something, you'll know something.
Thanks, Detective Paris. It was great talking to you.
Ditto.
Hey, Nancy, what's up?
I'm afraid I got off on the wrong foot with Elliot. I spilled paint all over something he'd been working on.
Ooh, not good. The guy's already about a month behind in his work.
Any idea why he's so far behind?
He's a procrastinator. Doesn't really like to work, so he does whatever he can to avoid it. Puts things off till the last minute. Me, I get stuff done right away. You do too, I'll bet.
Well, I try. Has he always been behind?
I guess he was doing okay up until about a month ago. Way I hear it, if he doesn't get caught up, like, fast, he's gonna be waving bye-bye, like, soon.
I'll see you around.
Sounds good.
Alrighty. Well, I'm just going to check our to-do list real quick. See how everything's going. Okay, we can't do that yet. We have to wait for Ingrid to leave. Keep checking email. I did this before for a science experiment in elementary school. In Ironaut's very low setting, we usually do the trick. That's why we have access to the iron here. So we're going to get a secret message written in lemon juice at some point. What I did with my science experiment was I actually just held the paper over like a light bulb from a lamp that had been left on for a long time. That works too. Well, I think I'm actually going to stop here for now. We have met all the relevant people, I believe. So, it's possible that somebody stole the carousel horse because there were stolen jewels hidden inside it. That would be pretty cool. As for suspects, it's too early to make a call. We know that Joy has a bit of a grudge against Paula, for valid reasons, I'll say. And we don't really know enough about the other people yet. It's way too early to try and decide who it is. So, next time, I guess we're gonna try and... I don't know the word. Not make friends exactly, but get Elliot to stop being so mad at us so that we can actually get the stuff we need from him. Hopefully that works out. Oh, and we need to get the soldering gun so we can put the thingy back on the access pad at the roller coaster. So yeah, that's what we're gonna work on next time. So, thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next time. Bye.